Hello, and welcome to theCUBE's Tech Innovation Cubed Awards, where we celebrate our inaugural program winners. Now, this year, the competition was fierce, and we received exceptional number of high-caliber entries that really showcase the incredible innovation that's happening across the tech landscape. Today, I'm fortunate to be joined by Shlomo Kramer from Cato Networks to discuss their award-winning entry and how he and his company are driving the industry forward. Now, Shlomo, you took one of the top honors in the most innovative tech startup leaders category. So congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Great. Yeah. And let's get started. I mean, clearly innovation is central to these awards. I'm wondering if you could share with everyone a specific example of how you or your company approached a challenge in an innovative way and what impact that had.
Yeah, so at Cato, for example, we looked at the market, and the market was the network security and networking markets, and there were still very much appliance and point solution based, which was the fundamental method through which innovation has been created in the cybersecurity market for 30 years now. And we said, no, CISOs can't have dozens and dozens of solutions anymore. We'll create a platform, a cloud platform that will simplify, converge all these point solutions into a single service, cloud service. Very much like AWS did for data centers, we want do it for networking, network security. That was completely contrarian at the time. And today it's part of a whole movement of the platforms as cloud platforms and endpoint security platforms and SASE, which is the network security platform.
Yeah, absolutely. It's clear that with the highly distributed and complex environments and highly dynamic environments, you can no longer rely on maybe a dozen individual technologies to be able to drive, right? You really need a lot more efficiency. So that platform approach, that ability to, what I also refer to as the principle of least astonishment, when you go from one function to another, to be able to have that platform that enables you to drive that operational efficiency is really so key. So I'm wondering if you look back over this journey, and in yours specifically, it was to creating the platform for SASE. Was there any specific either point, decision, or a key turning point that really helped lead you to where you are today?
I think the I can't look at a single a point. These were more a series of progressions. We were facing, you know, each startup has a different kind of challenge. Some startups in security address and yet unaddressed market, you know, mobile devices, IoT. And the challenge is, hey, will this market happen? Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. We came into a market with a completely new how, a platform, you know, AWS-like approach. And the challenge was, can we do it? Can we achieve it from an engineering perspective? Can we deliver a rock solid 5 nines a network on the one hand, and on the other hand, the most dynamic network security stack? So that required multiple points of a progression and invention. And each one of them looked like, hey, we've made it, and then you have the next hilltop to climb until we made it to the pass and before winter, as the expression says.
Yeah, absolutely. Like I said, and there's certainly a lot that goes into the SASE technologies and building that out. So it would make sense that it wasn't maybe one singular point, but the fact that over time, working with organizations, understanding what were the most important technologies to be included in that platform, right? Which were the priorities, and then building it out. So that makes a lot of sense. Yeah. So turning to you maybe a little bit more on a personal side, you know, throughout your career, What's been your most unconventional approach or perspective that initially may have raised eyebrows, but ultimately proved transformative in driving innovation or change?
So in each one of the three startups where I was a co-founder, Checkpoint, Imperva, and Cato, it was a completely contrarian approach. And in actuality, I think it's really important for a startup to have a contrarian approach, because that's the arbitrage you are working on and building on the fact that nobody else thinks that you see you. If you're right, you'll have the advantage. So with Checkpoint, we came, you know, the market was proxy firewalls. We came out with stateful inspection firewall. At Imperva, you know, nobody thought data security and application security are important niche markets, and why are they combined? Today, it's obvious that they are combined, and it's one of the biggest pillars in security. And in Cato, it was clear that nobody can, you know, the telcos own this, and they are the only ones that can provide the network. And the security vendors are the arms dealers for the security, so the telcos are going to provide it. And AWS, that's an approach that will not work in. So, yeah, in each one of them, a contrarian approach.
Oh, that's great advice. And certainly, like I said, if you're just going along with something just a little bit better, it's hard to make an impact. So taking that contrarian approach, standing out, being able to identify what the value is that you're bringing, and in this case, that converged networking and security across highly distributed environments, made a lot of sense and has led you to where you are today. So congratulations on that. I guess for the last question, there's, you know, we see that technology is always accelerating. It's always evolving. How do you and your team stay ahead of these industry trends while you're ensuring that you're creating meaningful solutions rather than just following the latest hype?
So first of all, we have the benefit of the platform. And, you know, just in 2024, we came out with digital experience management, IoT, EPP, XDR, and managed SASE platform for partners, which is like a banner year in terms of five different companies, point products. How did we do it? We have great engineering team, but still the key is that 80%, 90% of the engineering is in the platform. Each new function that uses the real estate that we have on the network and on the device takes 10% of the engineering. And so our train of innovation is the fastest train in the market. And from a customer perspective, implementing that is the easiest way, because just turning on a toggle. And it's ready. I want to qualify all of that, that all of these are innovations on the what. I think that one of the most important things that we are doing, and we are the most advanced in the world, and actually that's the key to our success, is the how. We bring a completely new how deliver these capabilities, security capabilities, in a way that is operationally efficient, in a way that is business agile, essentially digitally transforming the how of network security and networking.
Yeah, it sounds great. And obviously, a lot of work, your ability to innovate is being driven by the work you put in up front in that platform. So that makes a lot of sense that you're not having to, you know, recreate the wheel every time you want to add new technology. You're able to slot it in at a fraction of the time, which is obviously going to enable you to continue to accelerate that innovation. Listen, this has been really great. Thank you so much for your time. And again, congratulations on your award. We certainly look forward to seeing your entry next year and all the innovation you bring out in 25. And wanted to thank all those who are watching theCUBE and following the Tech Innovation Cube Inaugural Awards. We'll see you all next year.